ugly friends. Honestly, I don't.
Dating in the dark.
Oh my God, it's scary.
It's the show where looks don't count. At least not until the very end.
He looked like an elf.
This week, three guys, two girls, and Saxgate's Georgina Baillie will attempt to find love.
There doesn't appear to be a shirt.
In a pitch black room. But when the lights turn on, who will be turned off?
No. That was not working for me.
Or will it be love at first sight?
She is un-bloody believable.
Search for a soulmate starts right here in this house. And inside are six singletons, all hoping to find love. First up, it's the girls.
I'm Georgina, I'm 24, and I'm from London, and I'm a singer in a band. I'm best known for being at the centre of the Saxgate scandal, which involved Jonathan Ross and Russell Brand making a prank call to my granddad. I feel on the back of the scandal, men just see me as someone who's easy, and I'm really not. I'm after something more serious at the moment. I hope to find a guy who is not my usual type and the person who is right for me, ultimately, because I think I deserve to find true love.
I'm Lucy, I'm 31. I teach acting to children and I come from Essex. I'm bubbly. I'm vivacious, I'm fairly attractive, but I am no Kate Moss. A man has to make me laugh. If they can make me laugh now, then they can make me laugh in 30 years. I want to meet someone who I can have a life with, and I'd like to meet him here.
My name is Rebecca, I'm 31, I'm a fashion designer and I live here in London. I'm a very glamorous woman. I like to look good all the time. I would probably admit I've been on at least 50 dates in the last 6 months. Sometimes I've dated twice in one day. I would love to meet the man of my dreams. I'm really, really crossing fingers. Please, please find me my Mr. Right.
Living in a separate apartment downstairs are the guys.
My name's Richard. I'm 29 years old. I'm a drummer. I once supported Bon Jovi and I work in promotions. I'd like to think I was quite striking. Girls have said that I've got quite chiseled features, similar to Tom Cruise, Freddie Lundberg. For me, it's quite important to have a good-looking girl on my arm. Maybe that's an ego thing. Maybe I just like to be seen with a good-looking girl.
My name's George. I'm from London, born and raised. I'm 28 years old, and I work in video games PR. I'd say that I was high-energy, passionate. Sometimes I don't know where to draw the line. But you know what? I think to label yourself is to limit yourself, so I wouldn't really want to tie myself down to just one trait. I have probably got the capacity to come across as being really arrogant. Personally, I think that my chat is probably better than my looks, so going in the dark room, I may even have an advantage. Who knows?
My name's Phoenix. I'm 32 years of age. I'm from East London. I'm an actor, writer, and model. Being a model, my whole world is based around looks. I'm often around pretty women all the time, constantly. And that's fine, but there's a lot more depth to me. I'm a very spiritual person as well. And that's kind of what I'm looking for, someone with a bit more depth than just a pretty face, basically.
With the data settled in, it's now time for the guys and girls to meet as they enter the dark room for the very first time.
Have you found a settee yet?
Yeah.
You got it? Okay.
Oh,
yeah. Are you comfy?
Yeah.
This is nice.
You know what? I don't think I've ever been in a room that dark. I don't. I don't think it was just pitch black.
Oh, my gosh. Which way am I going?
Forwards.
Forward. Oh, my gosh.
Okay. Hello, ladies.
Oh my God. That's not fair.
Oh, man, that was brilliant.
Can you see us or something?
Yeah, we can see you. They gave us night vision goggles.
Yeah, just for the boys.
The fact that we couldn't see the girls kind of took away, for me, a little bit of the pressure.
I'm Lucy. For a job, I run a theatre company that sends plays around to primary schools.
Is that like Legs Akimbo?
I hope not.
How disappointing, right? Sorry. That's minus 3 points already.
I do apologise. I'm sure we can work something out, though.
I'm the type of person who probably engages their mouth before they remember to switch on their brain.
My name's George, and I work in PR, which is unfortunately the least interesting career.
No, it's not.
No, it is. No. But thanks, I appreciate that. Who said that?
Rebecca. I think George, he's quite a confident guy, but I think he's, you know, had a good education. He's quite well spoken.
I'm Georgina. I'm from London and I'm a singer in a rock band.
Very cool.
Nice.
Very cool.
You just don't know who you're sitting in front of or opposite, because it's just so dark. You could be sitting next to anybody, you know. It could be a transsexual, it could be a, you know, a celebrity. You just don't know.
I am Phoenix. I am a writer, model, poet and actor.
Crikey.
From East London.
Phoenix saying that he was a model obviously impressed me, because who doesn't want to date a good-looking guy?
I'm Richard, and I'm a drummer and work in promotion.
Oh, I see connections already.
you should ask him who he supported, seriously.
Go on then, tell us.
Bon Jovi.
Oh, I know.
I'm super impressed.
Cool. Yeah, that was good.
That is good.
To find that out about me, I think that really sort of scored me a couple of points. So, yeah, a bit of a bonus there, really.
Nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you guys.
At the moment, I think it is between George and Richard. I do like a guy who's confident, and George is that. So I'm not sure. I'm reserving judgment.
Having met as a group, the daters now get to pick the person they'd like to see more of as they embark on their first one-on-one dates.
I'm nervous, but it'll be interesting.
Well, fine.
Rebecca is first to the dark room, and she's chosen to date George.
I think George is quite, you know, good for me, because he is quite confident and a bit loud.
She seems like a really nice girl. I'm really looking forward to meeting her.
Imagine,
yes,
you find, like, a stargate, like a gate that can travel through time.
Okay.
And it can take you to anywhere or
right.
Anywhere.
Yes.
Where would you go?
Okay, I would go to the 1930s first in probably
Don't tell
Paris.
Me I went to Art Deco. If you're into Art Deco, I'm
yeah.
Literally gonna flip, no way! That's so cool!
You can't swear, you're so naughty!
Oh, no, I'm mad into Art Deco, no
yeah.
Way!
She seems like a pretty cool girl. We've obviously got stuff in common.
Your life, I would say, is full of and continues to have quite a lot of change in
wow,
it.
Wow, you're very good,
thank
yeah.
You. And then the future, so you're a very curious person,
yes.
And you dream a lot. You've got your head
yes,
in the clouds, I would
I
say.
I do, yeah, I have a dreamer's dictionary as well. He got me to a T, I think it's amazing. I think the intelligence, amazing, very good. Very good. Thank you.
Have
nice
a good
to
one.
Meet you.
You
it
too.
Went so quickly.
I know.
Oh, do enjoy.
Yeah, we'll do.
It's too early to say. I'm not sure what she thinks of me, and up until I've had a chance to really get to know her better, everything's to play for.
Have fun.
Bye.
Georgina and Richard are the next couple to go on a first date.
We're both musicians, and, you know, I think we're going to have a lot of common ground and a lot to talk about.
I'm a bit scared of going on a date in the dark, not because it's in the dark, but because I won't be able to hide behind my looks like I usually do.
Do you mind if I feel your hair?
Yeah, touch the hair.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, it's quite
it's a little... Oh,
well,
quite...
I'm not going to say anything.
Yeah.
It's hair.
I thought it would be longer, to be honest, but I'm not disappointed.
When I felt Richard's hair, I was a little bit disappointed because I liked long hair over short hair.
I was going to ask you if you'd like to kiss, but I think I'll leave that till later on.
I think, kiss on the first date.
No, I don't do that, so that's why I'm not going to ask you.
I said no because I don't kiss on the first date, and I thought it was a bit cheap and tacky that he asked me on the first date anyway. Hug.
Hug, there
we go. Bye.
Take it down.
I did ask Georgina if she might want to give us a kiss, and I got knocked back, and that kind of destroyed me a little bit. You know, perhaps next time she won't kick me back twice. We'll see.
Take it easy, Rev. Good luck.
Phoenix is the last guy to go on a first date, and he's also chosen to meet Georgina.
Good luck.
I chose Georgina for my first date because she seemed the most warmest and fun of all of them.
I'm very happy to be chosen by Phoenix. I have a thing for male models. Who doesn't?
How do you write? How do you go about it?
I've always had this rule of, you know, you write whenever, wherever you are kind of thing.
Yeah.
But if I'm, like, out somewhere, I haven't got any paper, you know, or just got my phone, I'll put stuff into my phone. Like,
oh, my God, I do that too.
Yeah.
So in, like, an empty text message.
And save it as a draft.
Oh, my God!
Yeah.
Okay, I so did a girly squeak, I'm sorry.
That's
oh,
cool.
My God!
I think I have more in common with Phoenix. We're into our music and
and lyrics and poetry very similar. Can I feel your arm, please?
Go for it.
OK, now make sure you really give me your arm, not something else.
OK. You'll be a tip difference up, so I could have done.
I think that he's black, about 6'2", nice broad shoulders, good skin and good hair, for short hair. Oh, am I...
Frisk me, baby.
It's all right. I think you've had enough frisking for one afternoon.
I have to say, I really enjoyed being touched by Georgina. I really loved it.
See if I get a word in edgewise.
Good luck.
Good luck.
The next pair to date are Lucy and George.
I'm excited. I'm a little bit nervous. I mean, it's going to be exciting because we both picked each other and that's nice.
I just want to see what happens, you know, see the man behind the mouth.
Are you a bit of a thasp?
A little bit, yes, but
good.
I also...
Good, that's, I would high-five you, but I'd probably punch you in the face, so...
Yeah, perhaps best not.
Bad luck.
Oh, that's
my knee,
that's my knee.
We can carry on doing that.
All right.
It's a solid knee.
It is.
I have two real legs.
You do?
I know.
Wow.
Oh, my God, it's great.
With George, I think there was quite a strong connection. I got the feeling that it was mutual.
Right, would you say that you've got a vivid imagination?
Yes.
Would you say that you're someone who's quite in touch with their own emotions?
I get passionate about things.
Well, that's good. Passion is, that is a high five moment. Find my hand and touch it. No, where is
oh,
it?
No.
Yeah, yeah. There it is. Yeah, that'll do.
The more we talked, the more I liked him, if you see what I mean. So, kind of, he's really sweet.
I'm having a lot of fun, by the way.
I am, actually.
Good.
Yes.
Good. Well, this is fun. We should do it again
sometime.
I'd say it was very nice to meet Lucy one-on-one. Yeah, it was good. I mean, the other girls are going to have a lot to live up to.
A popular Lucy has been invited straight back to the dark room by Phoenix.
I'm very excited about going on a date with Lucy. You know, I've got a very nice impression from her in the group date.
At this stage, I'm actually quite disinterested in going on a date with Phoenix. He's going to have to do a lot to wow me.
Can you read... Can you tell me a bit of poetry? Something you've written? Can you recite something for me?
Dear.
Oh, I'll put you on the spot now, haven't I?
I don't usually do it on the first night. But here I am, transfixed in this moment in time again, behind my eyes again, inside my mind again, between her thighs again. And I'm tasting her like the pleasure's all mine again.
I was slightly shocked with regard to the poem, I have to say.
And for every breath I take, she takes four. And every sound she makes, I want more.
It's not my cup of tea. It was nice and rhythmic, but it's really... I was... very shocked. That's not what I expected at all. That was really good. He's really good.
Thank you.
I don't think I'd like to see Phoenix again. Bless him, he's a nice lad, but I don't think we have that much in common.
After a fun date with George and an awkward date with Phoenix, Lucy goes for the hat trick and dates Richard too.
He's the one I picture least, so I really kind of want to get an idea about who he is and that sort of thing.
Do you want to touch me if you want?
I
want
to feel
sort of
the hair. I'm sorry, I think...
Just work your way up to the hair there. Yes.
Yeah, oh, I see. Yeah. I'm thinking mohawk, but it's... I don't know where I got mohawk.
Mohawk? Really?
Richard is probably more like someone who I would go out with.
Oh, I see you there.
Yeah.
Yeah, just get a bit of the hair there. Well, that's nice. I think.
It's hair.
Yeah, it feels great. Let's have a hug.
Aww.
Here we go.
She just feels great, to be honest with you. Things are in the right places, nice and firm.
You give good hugs, I have to say. You do give hugs.
Richard has actually put a little bit of a spanner in the works. You know, he surprised me, so I'd like to see where that surprise can lead.
Still to come, Richard gets turned on.
That feels nice.
Yeah?
Hmm.
And Georgina gets turned off.
Do you have children?
I have two.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
So far on Dating in the Dark, Phoenix and Georgina have bonded, Rebecca's keen on George, and Richard's taken a shine to Lucy and Georgina. It's time for the daters to find out who their perfect match is, according to science.
I'm really nervous about this part, actually. I think this is the most nerve-wracking bit so far.
Kind of hope my match is Lucy, actually. I guess if she's anybody else's match, I'd be a little bit disappointed about that.
The compatibility test pairs up our daters with whom they're most similar, in areas such as open-mindedness, vanity and humour. It even tells them exactly how compatible they are.
Oh, God, the tension is killing me, the suspense.
Time to reveal the first match.
Lucy!
Okay.
Ooh, okay.
Lucy and George. Lucy and George.
Well, I can't say I'm that surprised.
Yes! I knew it.
I have to say, I'm a little bit jealous of George being matched with Lucy because I kind of took more of a shine to Lucy.
A score of 50% or above means a couple have a lot in common.
Ooh! 662! Wow.
Wow, that's nice. Really good.
I think I get some love in the dark later.
The traits we're matched on are sociability.
Humour.
Well, I'm very funny.
You are.
If I was to be matched with anybody about anything, I'm really glad that it's humour.
Oh, I was right, Becca.
Richard.
Ooh. Richard.
Me.
Well, that's a turn up with the books.
I'm really surprised.
I'm really surprised.
Really surprised?
78%.
Oh my gosh.
That doesn't happen every day.
That's really high, isn't it?
Yeah.
Wowzers.
Ambition.
Oh,
yeah.
That's a good one.
No,
Intellect.
Intellect. That makes sense.
Humour.
I was about to say that. I'm not joking. Seriously. Yeah? You guys have the same sense of humour.
Yeah? I genuinely was shocked. I thought it might be George, but it's actually Richard. We probably do have more in common. We just haven't found out yet.
Georgina.
That's my name. Phoenix.
Ooh,
shocked. 69. That's awesome. Well done.
I am shocked, actually. I thought we'd be less compatible than that.
Vanity. Ooh.
Hey, that doesn't surprise me.
Extrovert. So we're both vain and extrovert. Brilliant.
Great. I'm kind of over the moon, to be honest, because we got on so well. A lot, you know, various things we just kind of clicked, I feel. So very excited, looking forward.
Having found out who their matches are, the guys and girls now get to put science to the test and date their compatible partners.
Wish me luck. My date awaits me.
First up are Phoenix and Georgina, who match closely on extroversion. Extroverts are dominant and sociable people who are very competent at social interactions.
I hope Georgina is as happy as I am that we're compatible because, you know, we got on really well, you know. So, just hoping that she feels the same way.
I do feel good about being compatible with Phoenix. He seemed like someone who I could get on with really well.
I actually brought you a tutu.
A tutu?
Yeah, it's here.
Oh, wow.
Just
I've got
pop
a tutu.
It on.
Phoenix, I think, was a bit weirded out by my ballet lesson, but he joined in and he was a good sport.
We're going to go down. Bend your knees.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, click.
I really enjoyed doing ballet with Georgina, and I would very much like to do more.
And twirl.
Twirl. Okay.
Gracefully, darling.
Like tiptoeing.
Yes.
The date with Phoenix was going so perfect, and I just wanted to be sure before I made any decisions. So I asked myself, is there anything else that you want to know?
I hope you don't take offence to this, but do you have children?
I'm offended at that. No, yes, I do.
You do? How many?
I have two.
Two?
They're 9 and 10.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have kids, and I just don't feel like I'm ready to be someone's stepmother at 24.
It doesn't matter to me if he had or he hadn't, by the way.
Okay.
Cool. Oh, good.
I felt like the conversation flowed a lot less easily after I found out that he had kids.
Cool. Let's have a little... Let's call it a hug for now.
Okay.
Where are you?
Wait.
It was a great date with Georgina. I really enjoyed it. I connected with her a lot, I feel. So, yeah.
Part two of the love story.
Good luck!
The next compatible couple to date are Lucy and George.
I'm really happy that I matched with George. It's what I thought, so I'm really happy.
I'm really looking forward to spending more time with her in the dark room. We had a great giggle with each other yesterday.
Right.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'd give you a kiss, but it'd be like...
Oh!
Brilliant. Well, that was great. I really probably... Ooh. Oh, no, it's fine. I should have put the tray down beforehand. And my trousers are really wet.
If anything, spilling the champagne lightened the mood, because it gave us something to bond over.
all that was on your face.
George tried to feed me a truffle and kind of missed and scraped out my face.
Mm-hmm. Ah, those are the noises I like. This is good. This is encouraging.
The date was quite flirty, but I don't really think that there was any great chemistry. chemistry. I didn't feel like I wanted to, you know, rip her clothes off with my teeth or anything.
Well, this has been fun.
It has.
Let's do this again.
Yay.
Cool.
I would like to see George again, but I just want to see if Richard, if I have the same connection with Richard or not.
The final compatible couple are Richard and Rebecca. They matched closely on ambition, which is a key driver of achievement. So couples with extremely different levels of ambition face a bleak future.
I think with Richard, I want to get to know him better, I want to have this date, and actually concentrate on him. The other two I'm not interested in now.
I think sparks may fly with me and Rebecca. Who knows, but I did get on with Lucy really well.
Would you like to put these boxer shorts on? I'm going to decorate them for you.
Oh, my God, OK.
In the fashion world, I've done so many challenges, but I've never designed in the dark before. Now, I've got some goodies to... OK, yeah, I can feel...
I thought having Rebecca on her knees in front of me designing some pants for me was quite funny. It's a little bit saucy as well.
If I get too close, I'll shout, yeah.
You can't get too close.
There we go.
That feels nice.
Yes?
Hmm.
I get the impression that Rebecca might be a little bit possessive, a little bit needy from putting her name on the boxer shorts. It's kind of an ownership thing. That's what the message, you know, that's what kind of a message it puts across to me.
Do you mind if I hold your hand?
Yeah?
Yeah, just to get a bit of a connection there.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll give it a little kiss.
Oh, thank you.
Do you like that?
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
I did have my arms around Rebecca's waist and I did want to kiss her.
You've been smoking, haven't you?
No, just passively outside.
Oh,
I do smoke.
Richard.
I've been blown out now twice in 2 days by two girls, so I'm a little bit gutted about that.
See you later, darling.
Oh, God, don't forget your pants. Even if Richard was the best-looking guy in the world, I'm still unsure because I don't think we have that much in common.
Still to come, it's the dater's last chance to impress.
It's dribbling down my legs in the wrong direction.
Blimey.
Before the lights are turned on. So far on Dating in the Dark, Georgina has gone off Phoenix, Lucy is torn between Richard and George, and Richard, well, he fancies Lucy, Georgina and Rebecca. There's just one more round of dating until the lights are turned on and the daters see each other for the very first time. The guys and girls get to choose who they want to invite on this final date in the dark.
Bye, guys.
After an awkward compatibility date with Phoenix, Georgina has invited Richard on a final date.
I'm just looking forward to seeing if he lives up to the hype because all the other girls seem to like him quite a bit.
Sometimes I work as a naked butler, and for my last date with Georgina, I'm actually going to be going into the dark room with a tray of aphrodisiacs, so it could get quite saucy.
This is a bow tie.
This is a bow tie.
There doesn't appear to be a shirt.
There's no shirt.
Oh, nice tummy, though.
Oh, thank you.
And, oh, a little cuff.
A little cuff.
Is there one on the other side?
There might be one on the other side, yeah. What are you thinking?
Is this an apron?
Might be an apron. It's kind of something that I... It's kind of something that I do on the side.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You know, I'm not going to feel under the apron.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know. But I think I've figured... So you're a waiter who doesn't wear any clothes?
Yes, a scantily clad one.
I was surprised that Richard is a naked butler. But, you know, whatever works for him, if he doesn't make that much money with his drumming, then I guess he needs to do something else.
Here we go, the flake's coming in. In fact, I'm going to put the flake in my mouth and I'm going to feed you.
OK.
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
My date with Georgina was a bit of a giggle, to be fair. I think she quite enjoyed the fact that I was pretty much naked.
I would never have another opportunity to feel a naked man like this.
Just feel me, you know. I'll lay back and just touch away.
Yeah. I'm just relishing every moment right now. Oh, it's so nice. Yeah.
Can you massage?
To be honest, I was only touching him to make him feel special and less like a bit of an idiot for showing up naked.
You give me a boner, by the way. Just kidding. Just messing.
Okay, I was just scratching your back to be nice.
Do you want a strawberry? How about a strawberry?
Okay, yeah, that'll make it all better.
Yeah, I'll give you a strawberry, that's cool.
I don't waste my time with men who don't realise how special I am. Bye-bye, Richard. Bye.
See you.
I was like, oh, damn. But at the same time, you know, I think I prefer Lucy, so it's not all that bad, really.
Phoenix is the next guy to the dark room. He's chosen to meet Georgina.
Georgina invited Richard for a final date as opposed to me, which I'm really surprised about, because she said she got on with me most out of everyone.
I was really happy that Phoenix chose me for his final date because we had a lot in common. However, there were a few negatives which I feel like we should discuss more. I wanted to ask you, actually, about your kids, if you wouldn't mind.
Yeah, go for it.
So, you said that you don't see them as much as you'd like to.
I see them as much as I can and spend as much time as I can with them, you know, that's very important to me. You know? But when you're young and wild, you know, and reckless, you don't think about these things, you know?
I really sympathise with that because I've done a fair few stupid things, like, in my past. I feel a bit better about the children situation. I've got my mind open and I'm just willing to see what he's got to offer.
J'espère jouer avec vous plus tard, monsieur.
Wow.
I hope to be able to play with you later. Est-ce que tu aimes? Do you like it?
Oh, yes, I love it.
She could speak to me like that all night, seriously. She's turning me on.
No, let's wait till later.
for
are you pulling me in for a kiss there?
Oh, wow. Well,
Sparky. Yeah.
Did it feel like I was?
Yeah, a bit. Oh,
okay.
I think Phoenix is definitely my type. I really... decent, normal guy, which surprisingly is what I like.
You know, I should just take the opportunity.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Have a grope in the dark.
Yeah, well, that's why it's still dating in the dark. After me and Georgina's final date, I think we've overcome a lot of things. I really want to see her in the light. I'm looking forward to it.
Good luck!
Next up are Rebecca and George, who picked each other for their final date in the dark.
The reason why I've chosen Rebecca for my final date, I guess, is because she presents more of a mystery, and Lord knows I love a good mystery. She's really intriguing.
I picked George for my final date because I was curious to find out more. Okay, I have something fun for you to do.
Excellent, let's jump straight in.
Okay, have you ever been wine tasting before?
I have been wine tasting.
Have you?
Yeah, I know how to... No, it's great.
May I ask, you're not too clumsy, are you?
No, I'm not clumsy. Sure. What would give you that idea?
So when I was handed the glass of wine, I was a little bit worried. I was thinking, oh, God, I spilled it last time. I really hope I don't spill it this time.
Make sure you get it all around your palate, darling, sweetie.
Mm.
Yes, and there it is. Don't spit it on me. I won't approve. You can swallow it.
Oh, I didn't know that I get it on you.
Yes.
That so wasn't my fault.
It's dribbling down my legs in the wrong direction.
Blimey. You've only been in the room 5 minutes, or you're dribbling down your legs.
Crikey, young man. It was funny, I suppose. It wasn't a problem. After that, we just decided it's best to swallow. If I was to take you to a party or anywhere with me, I do think you would just get on with everybody.
I'm nodding now. I'm nodding.
Yeah, so am I. As a person, I think he's absolutely amazing. He's so cool, so funny. I think we have so much in common and we'd get on really, really well.
Can I pay a physical compliment? Some girls are a bit iffy about physical compliments. But you've got a great figure.
Thank you.
A really great figure.
Thank you very much. It's very kind.
No, it's fine.
I gelled with her the best, and yeah, it was really, really positive. Great, great fun. Much better than I thought it would be, and I thought it would be pretty fun in the first place.
The last pair to go on a final date are Richard and Lucy.
The fact that I chose Lucy and Lucy chose me really sort of fires me up and gives me a lot of confidence going into the date.
I am a little bit upset that George didn't pick me for his final date, but then again, I didn't pick him, so I can't really complain.
If you'd care to join me on the drum kit...
Oh, my God,
rhythm. You're going to have a little lesson in percussion.
OK, cool.
Yeah. I was able to teach her how to do a bit of drumming. She's never done that before, so she loved that.
Can you just get your hands here? it's quite an intimate process. So we've got the... Where's the hi-hat? Where's that? There we are.
He was very good, very good teacher, very positive, but I wasn't that good.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. That's it. You're drumming.
I am.
Doing it in the dark was very strange because you're hitting things, you can't see them, but she did really well.
What sort of girl do you normally go for then? What type of girl?
Which do I prefer?
I will pin you
Lucy,
down.
Lucy, I prefer your type of girl.
Oh, you're such
of
a charmer.
I do. You're just a perfect girl.
Well,
you know, you're a real gem.
Oh, bless you.
Richard was a charmer, but in a nice way.
I'm just confused now.
What are you confused about?
I'm just confused.
Come on.
It may be good for you, respect.
Oh, brilliant.
I need to think.
How about if I give you a kiss? Would that help?
It might do.
Where are you? Oh, God.
Where's your face?
Lucy had fantastically generous lips, really full lips, really wonderful to kiss, yeah. I enjoyed that.
I think we need to...
Have a cold shower, mister. See you, my dear.
The fact that Richard is a good kisser has thrown me into immense confusion because it is important to me and I haven't kissed George, so... I just don't know what to do.
Did you kiss him?
We had a fantastic time together. We kissed, and I want to see what she looks like.
The romancing is over, and the daters now get to pick one person to see in the light.
I can't wait to see what the girls look like. I'm so intrigued, and yeah, the anticipation is the big word right now.
I'm a bit scared, actually, a bit nervous. It's definitely a make or break.
This is going to be the big icebreaker, the big decision maker.
Will their love interest live up to their high expectations? Or will their connection end here? It's time to turn on the lights.
Right, I'm off.
First up, Rebecca and George have requested to see each other in the light.
I think we got on really well. She's a really interesting character, and the type of world that she inhabits is very, very appealing to me.
This is a huge moment for me because I actually think George is an amazing guy. Obviously, what he looks like is going to determine whether I'm going to fancy him or not.
The daters cannot speak during the light and can't evidence.
He's really ugly. It'd be awful. I don't have ugly friends. Honestly, I don't.
I'd be pretty crushed if, you know, Rebecca said, you know, he's not my type and just walked away.
Actually look him up and down because I was so shocked and actually thought my eyes were deceiving me because he was nothing like I expected. I don't think he's that old, but seriously, he dresses like he's an old man. That's not a quirky style at all. That's just, no. Oh, no.
Oh, great.
That, it just, no. That was not working for me, not at all.
She is un-bloody believable. Seriously,
really?
She's a very, very attractive lady.
She is absolutely stunning. You know, I feel like I should be reining it in right now, but no, she's a very, very good-looking girl.
Good to meet you.
Good. Thanks, man.
The next daters to request to see each other in the light are Phoenix and Georgina.
I'm very excited about seeing Georgina. I think we're gonna really hit it off together.
Looks have always been important to me because I feel like I can't go to bed with someone unless I find them really, really attractive.
If she is anything like the image I have in my mind, I am going to want to run over, hold her in my arms and just kiss and hug her.
Hopefully, if he's not an oil painting, I can somehow manage to overlook it.
Georgina is 100% better looking than I could ever have imagined. She, for me, has the whole package. She has the looks, the shape, everything physically, a nice face.
Oh, okay.
So he is a model how?
Oh!
Like, what the what? Hell?
Do you want to see her again then?
Oh, yeah, I want to see her right now.
Yeah,
oh,
really?
Mate.
Don't want to be with you, look.
Oh, mate, I'm jealous.
Oh, she's nice, man. She's beautiful. She is.
If he is a male model, he clearly hasn't modeled for quite a few years. And I don't know what kind of agency he's with.
Okay, here I go, girls.
Good luck. Hope you enjoy it.
Finally, Lucy and Richard have asked to see each other in the light.
I do have a few concerns about seeing Lucy in the light reveal today. What happens if I've been kissing a monster, somebody that's really ugly, for example?
I think that Richard and I are on the same level looks-wise. Good looking, but not supermodel quality.
I do like to have a good-looking girl on my arm, so if she isn't as good-looking as I thought she would be, yeah, it's a shame to say, but I probably wouldn't be seeing her again.
If Richard is good-looking, he's got a great personality, then there may be a future. Who knows?
To be honest with you, when the light came on Lucy, she wasn't actually as attractive as I thought she would be. Just something about a face, maybe, or something like that, that I just don't usually go for.
He's hot.
Yeah?
Oh, my God, he's
really?
Hot. Yes. Yeah, I am glad I kissed Richard. Particularly as he turned out to be good-looking.
Still to come. The daters decide whether to meet up or walk away. After three rounds of dating in the dark, the couples have finally seen each other in the light. So, are they keen to learn more, or are they ready to turn the lights out on the future? It's the moment of truth. If they're still interested in their partner, they will go to the drawing room. However, the daters will not know if their partner is already waiting for them, or if they will turn up at all. If they're no longer interested, they will walk out the front door, potentially leaving their partner behind. After seeing Georgina in the light, Phoenix has made his decision.
Bert's going to meet Georgina in the drawing room. Yeah, I'm very excited. I want to see Georgina a lot. I think she looks great. There's lots we gel on, you know, together. So I hope, you know, I hope we can make something happen.
I'm finding it really difficult to decide what I want to do. We've got loads in common. He's a great guy. I really am not sure what to do.
I find Georgina very attractive. When I saw what she looked like, I just wanted to grab her, basically, and, you know, snuggle and kiss her. Waited quite a while. It felt like a lifetime, pacing up and down, wondering which door she was going to come out of.
I decided to not meet Phoenix because I felt like it was the right decision for me and I just wasn't attracted to him.
She didn't come. She just walked away.
Phoenix had no idea that he was dating Georgina from Saxgate. He was dating just Georgina in the dark, no rubbish around it, just me being me. And it was a really nice, liberating experience.
Now learning that Georgina's famous, it doesn't put me off of her. She's got a great personality, you know, and I'd have liked to have got to know her more. I didn't find love this time, but I sincerely believe there's still someone out there for me.
I can't really think at this stage of a reason why I wouldn't want to date Rebecca. She seems like a really interesting person. She's obviously a very good-looking girl. You'd have to, you know, be blind not to realise that. She's very, very attractive in a classical, almost Hollywood-esque way.
I do feel better than I did yesterday. I think I was a bit harsh yesterday when I came out of my reveal. I must admit, George, his personality was great. We did get on really, really well, and I do have to remember that. Maybe not so good looking, but I think he's a fantastic guy and I think we could have a right laugh together. So that's going in his favour.
If I could see her walk away, you know what, it'd be pretty crushing. The way in the drawing room was pretty horrific, you know, I just didn't know what to do with myself. I was just, yeah, just a big bundle of anticipation.
I'm not actually going to go and meet George, only because I think I'd be leading him on if I did go, and realistically, in the real world, I wouldn't date George. I did come on Dating in the Dark to find my true man of my dreams. However, I haven't found him, and, you know, the story continues, I guess. Maybe one day I will find my Prince Charming.
Got it. I did feel really dejected that Rebecca didn't come into the room. It wasn't the most pleasant experience. So I didn't get to meet my Miss Right on Dating in the Dark, which is a bit of a shame. But you know what? There are plenty more fish in the sea. Just gotta head out to the ocean.
I'm like to go and meet Richard because we had a connection in the dark, and when I saw him in the light, he looked like the sort of guy that I would go for, so hopefully, he'll come and find me. I came to Dating in the Dark because I wanted to find a man, and I have found Richard, and I think there could be a future relationship between the two of us.
Right now, I'm feeling torn, twisted, emotional. I don't know what to do. It's really tough. Am I that shallow? Lucy really is an amazing girl. She's got a really fantastic personality. I mean, we could talk about nothing for hours and that'd be great. I'd feel entirely comfortable with her. But having seen her in the light, I'm just not sure I do want to see her again.
If Richard walks away and he doesn't come to meet me, I will be very gutted.
The decision to walk out of the house was one of the hardest I've ever made. On the one hand, you know, she's a fantastic person, great personality, but on the other hand, looks not quite there. I feel a little bit shallow about that, but at the same time, I'm not going to be beating myself up about it. I like attractive women, women that are sort of on my level, and that's just the way it is.
I am disappointed that Richard didn't turn up. You know, it's hard to get rejected. And to watch someone walk away is really hard, because I did want him to walk in the room. I wouldn't have gone in there otherwise. So, yeah, I am really disappointed. But if you don't take these chances, then you'll never get anywhere.